students, today we are looking at the part 4 of elasticity. In the last class, we looked at the part 3. So, and today, our lesson objectives. One, at the end of the lesson, students should be able to explain work done in springs and elastic springs. That's still the same. Explain work done in springs and elastic spring, and write the formula for work done. Then explain elastic potential energy. You know what potential energy is. Now, then to solve simple problems in work done and energy in elastic spring. So, work done in an elastic spring, what does it actually mean? You know what work done means? Work done, we always say that work is done when a force moves an object through a distance. So, but in elastic spring, what is work done? Work done is defined as the product of the average force and the extension. When you say average, you know what average means in mathematics. If you have maybe A, B, you have these two items. If you want to find the average, you add it together and you divide by 2. So the same thing with the average force here. The first one is 0. This is 0. Then the other force, which is capital F here. So by the time you take the average of 0 plus F, you have half F, then times the extension. This is the extension for the string. So then, elastic potential energy. Of course, you know what potential energy means. Potential energy is the energy possessed by a body due to the virtue of its position. So, but in what we mean by elastic potential energy now is the ability of the stretched or compressed elastic material to actually do work. So by the time you extend an elastic string, then a particular will be done by it, and that is the ability to do that particular work is what we call the elastic potential energy. And the same formula that you have for the work done in spring, that is still the same formula you have for the elastic potential energy. Then note, work done in stretching or compressing a material is the same as the energy stored in that material. So don't be surprised when we are using the same formula for energy and we are using the same thing for our work done. So let's consider these questions. One, a spiral spring is compressed by 0.02 meter. This is the extension, which is the 0.02 meter. Then calculate the energy stored in that spring. Let's say the energy stored is capital E. Then the force constant, which is your K, is 20 newton per meter. So you are going to use the formula for energy. E is equals to half KE squared. Or you can use half FE if force is known. But in this case, you don't know the force. You know the elastic constant, which is K. So then the next thing is to plug in your values. That is half times your K is 20. And your extension is 0.02. Then don't forget to square it. So 2 cancels 0.1. That's 10. And that will be 10 times 0.02 squared. So you can actually convert this one to standard form in order to get the final answer. So that's 10 times 4 times 10 raised to the power minus 4. This is going to give you 4 times 10 raised to the power minus 3. And what will be the unit? The unit for energy, of course, is joule. So this is the final answer for that one. Let's consider the last question. A spring is stretched 40 millimeters. That is the extension, 40 millimeter. Millimeter is not the extra unit of length. So you have to convert it to meter. That's 40 divided by 1,000. And that's 0.04 meter. Then the force is given in this case, 15 newton. You have to find the work done, which is question mark. So don't forget, I told you that work done formula is still the same for energy in a spring. So work done is equal to half, because you are given the force this time around, it will be half Fe. So which will be half times your force is 15 newton. Your extension is 0.04. This time around, you are not going to square it because you are using force to calculate it. So you have 2, we divide this one. So 15 times 0.02, and that will give you 80 over 100, which is 0.8. unit is also two. So when we meet the Google Classroom, I'm going to do more of this. Thank you.